Okay, I have a Windows 10 laptop here, and I have a Logitech HD 1080p camera.
And the camera I'm using here is actually the Logitech C930e.
I'm going to take this USB cable from the webcam. This is the first time I've ever plugged it into the laptop. It's a pretty brand new laptop, though. The camera itself is not new. And I hear a little chime, which usually means that the USB is being established, the connections, the drivers are getting configured. Okay, now in order to change the settings or even bring up a preview, you want to go to an app called Camera, and you can find that here in the search down below.
Okay, so the first thing you want to do is you want to go to the search bar down below here and put in Camera, and locate the Camera app that's installed on Windows 10 by default. Now here you can see my screen, the webcam from the laptop you just saw a moment ago is now pointing to me from the side while I'm looking at you with a different camera facing forward. That's not the important part of this. The important part is to see how we can configure the settings so that we can scale this camera out. Now if you look at the webcam here, the image over here, you'll see that it's got a wide angle. It's got my computer, it's got me, it's got almost the whole, in fact it does, it has the whole wall of the room. So a lot of times what happens, and maybe it's not this exact scenario, but what a lot of times happens is that you want that camera to zoom in a bit so that the green screen is the only thing visible other than you and the green screen. You don't want to see the background. So to do that, we're going to need to go into something called Camera Settings. Now, I brought up this first app here called Camera because this is where the basics are had. In other words, you can say, okay, what's my settings for when I take a picture with the webcam? What are my settings for when I do video? Right now I've got it on the video settings. So with that in mind, here's a couple of basic options that you can do right out of the box with this built-in software on Windows. If you click here, you have the opportunity to focus. So you can see here, I can actually make my webcam out of focus. That might be okay depending on my scenario. Most of the time people do want it on autofocus, but what happens a lot of times is that people are, let's say, demonstrating and they have their hand now in the foreground and the camera doesn't know whether to go with your face to be in focus or your hand. And sometimes people want to manually put that focus somewhere so they can determine where that is. But for the most part, I'd say 99% of the time you're going to leave it on autofocus. The next thing over here is the brightness, which could be a big factor, especially with webcams. Now, the older and more inexpensive the webcam, chances are the more light you need to compensate for the quality of the image. In other words, the more expensive cameras and/or webcams can compensate for low-level lighting conditions, but a cheap webcam simply can't. That's not what they're designed to do. So changing the brightness can really make a difference. So obviously this is too dark, and probably the default setting is just fine for this for now. Now this is not the top-of-the-line webcam that we're using that you see in the image over here with me looking from the side. That webcam is the Logitech C930e, which is decent, and it's still a high-def camera, but it isn't as good as, let's say, the Logitech Brio or some of the others. Although, mileage does vary, and there's a thousand, millions of people using Logitech 930 and the 920, and those are just perfectly fine for most people's needs. Now, the key to have success with a consumer-grade webcam is proper lighting. Here is a still image of me taken with that exact same camera. I just adjusted the laptop a little bit. I moved it towards the wall so it's pointing towards the wall. And I put a proper light in front of my face and just took a still image. You can see here that the brightness, the vividness, the quality looks very decent. So webcams really do need proper lighting for you to get the best results, especially with the Logitech C930e or anything lower. But it's not as good as, let's say, the $1,000 camera that I'm looking at you from here in the front. This camera is a lot better in low lighting conditions, a lot more crisp on the image. This is a Sony. It's got a much bigger lens, etc., etc. If you want to know specifically what it is, it's the Sony RX100 version 7. And this is the 7th version of this camera. So I finally figured out how to use it. And it's what I like about the camera that I just spoke about is that it's tiny. It's probably the highest quality point-and-shoot camera you can have. And I like tiny cameras because I'm always, you can see here the keyboards, I'm always putting these cameras hanging from some suspended item. And I don't want a really heavy camera to do that. I want it to be as light and agile as possible. Okay, but anyway, you didn't ask for any of that. What you want to know is the camera settings. So There's a few things you can do here in the settings themselves in this particular app. You can choose what kind of stream quality you're going to do. You generally want to go as high as it'll let you and as high as your bandwidth will allow. But if you have a lousy bandwidth, you can bring down the quality and potentially reduce some of the lag and the jagginess in the video by reducing the quality of the video. And then the flicker resolution is either 50 hertz or 60 hertz. Generally speaking, 50 or 60 is fine. I don't know too much about hertz settings and how that impacts the overall quality or any of that. I think higher is better as a general rule. Now, this software is built in. It's great, but it doesn't really give you exactly what we're looking for. In this video, we're looking for magnification settings or zoom settings so that we can move in and out like I'm doing here. See, I'm moving in and moving out. Now, I'm doing that on my camera manually with an autofocus toggle control, an actual button that I'm pushing or toggling. Webcams don't have buttons, so you need software to do that. So if you're using a Logitech webcam, which probably most of you are, those are some of the most popular ones, you can actually go to the Logitech website and click on Downloads. Then locate your particular product. I'm going to select Webcam, so Windows 10, Windows 10, Webcams, and then I'm going to select, the C930e. And what do you get with this? Well, you could download the firmware, and if you haven't already watched that, I have a video that you can look up above, and I'll link to that so you can see what it's like to update the firmware for the Logitech C930e. But what we're talking about is camera settings. So they actually include free software with your purchase, or even without your purchase, that you can download, and this software will allow you to do those zoom settings, which is the exciting part of this video, in my opinion. All right, so I'm going to save that, save as, and I'm going to put that piece of software on my desktop. I'll hide the browser now. And here it is, Logitech camera settings. I'm just going to double click that. That should bring up a traditional installer. I'll accept the installer conditions. And now it's going to install that software, the drivers and the necessary components to allow me to manipulate the camera through software. And this should work in any other program. In other words, this software is independent of Skype and Zoom and anything else you might be using it with. It sort of directly talks to the camera. And once it directly talks to the camera, you can control it as if you had buttons on the webcam. Now it's installed. So I have a new icon here called Logitech Camera Settings. Check this out. Okay, it does say a new version of camera settings is available. I'll install the update. Update error. Okay, well, I don't know what that's all about, but this is what I wanted to show you. Now, you're looking here. The preview screen is, in fact, the webcam over on the laptop. And we have options for some interesting things. You can obviously restore the defaults, and you can click plus here, and just like that, you can not only magnify, but you can pan around as if this camera was on its own tripod. Is that amazing or what? Now, obviously, there's limitations. It's not truly turning, but what it does is it says, find the biggest thing that I can view and utilize a situation where I can zoom in and then pan around. So this right here is the zooming and the panning. Okay, so there it is. Now, let's just say I had a green screen behind me in the image that you see here with the webcam. You can now zoom right in to just your face and therefore carving out only green screen. None of that monkey business around the green screen. So, here's what it looks like. Hello. And I think that really does solve it. So let's just say I had Skype open or GoToMeeting or some other Zoom, let's say. Now, Zoom might actually have these settings built in as well. If you go to the camera area, you might be able to zoom and pan, but maybe not. I'm not familiar with Zoom too much. I am familiar with GoToMeeting. GoToMeeting has no camera zoom in capability at this time. But if you had this software sitting on the side or in the background of your meeting, you can adjust this and it will and should override whatever it is that you're presenting through. A huge, huge benefit. Especially if you don't know how to do this, now you actually have a real option to get behind the green screen and stay behind the green screen, which is the whole purpose of buying a green screen. And that's really all there is to it. And then when you're done with your meeting, you can close the software. Now, I believe that this is smart where the next time I open it, it will memorize the settings that I last had. So if you're sitting in the same place and the green screen is where it used to be, you should be able to just open this up and have it go to the settings that it just had. It did. Look at that. It's still zoomed in on my head. If you want to ever go back to the default, you can just click Restore Defaults. And this should pan out. Yeah, see that? That's the true blue nature of the camera. And this right here, what you're seeing there, that's a problem because people who are using a webcam with the green screen, the frustration is it's showing way too much of my house. I wanted to show less house and more green screen. So this is what's going to solve that problem. Also note you have a thing here where you have a standard image or a widescreen image. So if I change it to widescreen, the problem gets even worse. It's even showing more of my room now. So generally speaking, you can go widescreen, but just magnify and zoom in to just your head in the green screen. Or you can go standard and start from that angle. Now I'll go down a little bit. Whoop. Up is down, down is up, left is right, right is left. I don't know, but there it is. Perfect. All right. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you gained something from it. Hopefully it made your life a little better today. You can get behind the camera that much more confidently. Being behind camera in general is an awkward, uncomfortable, non-human, natural thing. It is very, very intimidating at first, nerve-wracking, whatever you want to call it. It's very unnatural. But after doing it for several years now at this point, I can look into the lens and it's as if I'm talking to somebody. It almost makes no difference that I'm talking to a piece of equipment. And then hopefully it looks pretty natural to you when I'm talking to you, but you can eventually get to that point where talking in front of camera within a web environment or, you know, presentation environment is going to be natural. And just think about it this way. It is what it is. Whatever you're wearing, whatever the room looks like, and however you present yourself, it is what it is. I think this is the first time probably in history where people on camera are sort of slowly becoming better at becoming themselves and allowing themselves to be themselves, because obviously that is the best presentation when you're just yourself. All right. Anyway, enough of that. Talk to you later on the next video.